All right, welcome to Peyton Suds Report. Today is the 26th, Monday the 26th of July. And Peyton, go ahead and explain what this song's all about.
Yeah, hello, welcome back, everybody. And I know by the name, Peyton Suds Report, this is a Brewers YouTube show. But we have to talk about the Milwaukee Bucks. They won the championship for the first time in 50 years.
Down 0-2 to the Nets.
Yes.
And they win in 7. Down 0-2 to the Suns, and they win in 6.
Yep.
Four straight, yeah.
Against that talented Phoenix Suns team. I heard after the game that it was the first time a team in the playoffs had come back down 2-0 twice since the Pistons, I think, in 1989.
And you know what? The Suns, bottom line, they showed a lot of class.
Yeah, especially their coach.
Yeah, their coach.
Monty Williams.
Monty Williams, you want to give a shout-out to him? What did he do after the game?
After game 6, where the Bucks, of course, won, he went down to the Bucks locker room to congratulate them, which I've heard that done like once or twice, but I mean, that doesn't happen a lot, so.
Crowder had a good series for the Suns. Former what?
Marquette Golden Eagle.
Yeah.
We turned him. And Frank Kaminsky.
Oh, yeah. Frank the Tank.
Yeah.
He can play basketball, not just drink beer.
Yeah. But, of course, Devin Booker was a big star.
Yeah. He had 19 points only in the last game, but he dropped a 40.
Twice.
Not a 40-ounce of beer, but a 40-pointer, yeah. Well, let's talk about the Bucks quick.
Yeah, amazing.
I don't know. Did Giannis, I can't remember, did he do well that game? I can't remember.
Yeah, it ended up being fitting because he scored 50 points. The Bucks scored 105 and he scored 50. He scored just over half their points. And it was, like I said,
under half their points.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, just under. And like I said, it was their first championship in 50 years, so I guess it was fate.
Yeah, Tucker, Giannis, Middleton, Lopez, Holiday, Portis, Teague, Connington.
Yeah.
You know, the top eight, great series by everybody. They all contributed. Yeah. Connington had his games.
Yeah.
Portis had his games, fan favorite. Yeah. 16 points
Bobby,
in the championship game. But I don't know what else to say, man, but it's been a long time coming.
Yeah, it's a long time coming, and it's just amazing. Like, after the game, I've been really reflecting, and it's just amazing what this franchise has gone through in the past decade, from, you know, being terrible to drafting Giannis to building the Pfizer Forum. To just
selling the team,
yeah,
from Herb Cole,
yeah and a couple of guys from New York bought them, and there was some talk about maybe the Bucks moving, but they stayed, and good thing they did.
Yeah,
they were world
champions. I grew up in South Milwaukee, and when I was young, and in the 80s, I believe the Bucks were one of the winningest teams in the NBA.
Yeah.
Never won a championship. You know,
they always ran into those 76ers team, Celtics.
And who were some of their top players back in the day?
Well, Marcus Johnson.
Of course. Shout out to him.
Yeah, shout out. Brian Winters.
I liked him from deep.
Yeah. Yep.
Bob Lanier.
Yeah, Sidney Moncrief.
Sidney Moncrief. And their coach was
Nelson.
Yeah.
Don Nelson,
yeah. Anything last minute on the Bucks?
I was just going to mention P.J. Tucker. He had some really memorable moments at the parade, the championship parade.
Apparently he likes champagne.
Yeah. I didn't know that about him. But
not only does he like champagne, but the people in the front row that he spit champagne all over like champagne as well. Because he sprayed them all, didn't he?
Yeah, he. And then apparently the Bucks are dogs.
Oh, yeah, he said their dog, too. So not only did they get champagne in the first few rows, but it came from his mouth.
Yeah.
During a COVID pandemic might not be a good idea.
Yeah,
but.
And then everyone gets some rest except Chris Middleton and Drew Holiday. They, on Saturday, they flew to Tokyo.
Giannis.
Go right back to playing.
Giannis and his brother used to share tennis shoes in Greece because they couldn't afford each pair, and they sold sunglasses or watches on the street. That's well known.
Yeah, in Greece.
The Bucks took a chance on him on a 185-190-pound, 6'6" guy that nobody knew of, and he repaid them.
Yeah.
Instead of going to New York or L.A. or Miami, he was loyal. Loyal to Milwaukee, yeah.
Yeah, so shout out to Aaron Rodgers. Yeah. Maybe you should see what Giannis is doing.
Take some notes.
Yeah, take some notes. Yeah. Indeed.
Instead of a big head, maybe you reward the team that made you famous.
Yeah, right? That took a chance on you. And
all right, so we're going to move over to the Brewers. We're going to try to go quickly because we talked about your Milwaukee Bucks.
Yes.
Monday, July 19th was the day off. Tuesday, Wednesday, they played the Royals.
Yeah.
We lost. We lost 5-2 and 6-3, and we were at the Tuesday game.
Yes.
Actually.
Yep.
What do you have to say about those? I have Garcia. Three hits.
Three hits, and when Manny Pena had both of the RBIs.
That's right, he did, didn't he?
In the game, yeah.
Anderson gave up 2 earned runs. Wednesday's game. Lauer pitched decent. Yelich had 2 hits, which is rare.
Yeah, hopefully. well, we were thinking hopefully he was going to break out of it, but this weekend he didn't do.
He had his chances yesterday. We'll talk about that later. Yeah. But, you know, watching, he has a high on-base percentage. I get that.
Yeah, he walks a lot.
But he walks a lot. And I've seen runners in scoring position with him striking out a little too much lately.
Yes.
So yeah, I don't know, that's all I got. Like Forrest Gump, that's all I got to say about that.
Yeah.
Thursday was ironic. Another day off. 2-1
Yeah,
week.
Yeah.
Then they came into the series this weekend with the White Sox, and the White Sox are first in the American League Central. And Friday we won 7-1. There's an outfielder that is doing well lately.
Yeah, extremely well. Tyrone Taylor. We've talked about him. Every time he comes up to the plate, he looks like he's going to hit one 400 feet.
He swings with aggression. It's like he thinks the ball is Aaron Rodgers' face or something. And he tries to slam it into the seats, right?
Yeah, he hit on a Friday night, he hit a grand slam.
That was his first ever grand slam?
Yeah, in the majors.
And Talese and Navarez had 2 hits.
Yep.
Brewers won 7-1.
Yep.
Peralta went 4 innings, didn't get the win.
Yeah, because of last season, I think, to save his innings.
The young coach for the White Sox got thrown out of the game for arguing.
Yeah.
His name is?
Tony La Russa.
76-year-old Tony La Russa.
His first year managing was with the White Sox in 1979.
And here he is 40 plus years later, 76 years old, and he gets kicked out of a game.
Yeah.
I think that's classic. Saturday, Brewers 6, White Sox 1.
Yeah.
Home runs. Kind of like you said earlier, the Oprah show.
Yeah.
You get a home run, and you get a home
run. Yeah, 4 home runs in the game.
Wong hits his 8th. Tyrone Taylor, for the second day in a row, gets his 9th.
Yeah.
And then the slim Talese.
Yeah.
Just as slim as who?
Vogelback,
yeah.
Him and Vogelback just missed going to Tokyo for that track and field.
Oh, it's sprint championship?
Yeah.
Because they're
in
such good shape. Yeah. He's slim, yeah. He hit 2 home runs.
Yeah, they got him from the Blue Jays a couple weeks ago because of Keston Hewitt. He's just not hitting. And ever since they got him, he's been doing great.
Corbin Burns pitched 6 innings with 1 earned run. Oh, wait a minute. That wasn't Corbin Burns. That was, who pitched Saturday?
Yeah, that was Corbin.
It was. Oh, yesterday was Woodruff. That's right. Yeah, you're right. 6 innings, 1 earned run, 98 pitches, 2.12 ERA. So yesterday, unfortunately, Woodruff gave up. Had one bad inning.
He gave up 3 earned runs in the game, and all 3 runs came in the top of the second, including a 2 RBI single by Lance Lynn. Lance Lynn, starting pitcher.
I think that was his first hit because they play in the American League.
In a few years.
In about 3-4 years. So both, 2 of the 3 earned runs came from the pitcher, which is a no-no. He was throwing strikes down the middle just to get rid of him, and he, that next time.
You have to give him credit.
Next time he came up, Lance Lynn, I think Woodruff was throwing junk at him.
He threw 3 straight curveballs.
Like a wet noodle. That's out of respect. I mean, I know Lance Lynn was upset that he wasn't getting, but hey, that's baseball. He's the one who brought it upon himself by doing well.
Well, and he does that pitching against hitters. Can't that be done to him?
Correct, Tyrone Taylor had 2 hits again. Some of the talk on the Milwaukee Journal, when Kane comes up tomorrow from the IR, are they going to send Tyrone Taylor to Nashville?
I think whoever wrote that is still drunk from partying about the Bucks.
The Bucks, you're not sending a bat as hot as Tyrone Taylor down.
If they send him down, then I'm going to move to San Jose, California.
And I think Colton Wong has a few splinters on his butt from sitting the bench. And he may be going back again for the third time? Lorenzo Cain comes off the IR, and I was going to ask you, Peyton, there's been, the trade deadline ends this week, I think Saturday?
Friday.
Friday? Okay, well, you'd know. So what are you thinking?
I think first base might be an option, but, I mean, Rowdy Tellez is doing so well, but he's a lefty, mate. If they send down Keston Hiura, maybe they would run a righty option, especially because Craig Counsell likes the matchups.
Well, there's been some talk at third base. Travis Shaw might come back in August, sometime in August. But Urias is done well at third in the field and at the bat.
He has.
At the plate, yeah.
I think maybe some bullpen help too, especially like Devin Williams is injured now.
And they talked about bringing back one of David Stearns' worst moves. Jesus Aguilar.
I always cringe when I hear his name because fan favorite. He did such a great job. A
lot of energy in the dugout.
And then they traded him. They needed some pitching help when we traded him, so I can see why they made the trade, but they traded Jesus Aguilar for a guy named Jake Faria, who is not even in the organization anymore.
That's considered one of his worst moves, but one of his best moves was Adames.
Yes, right. He's, with all the impactful moves Stones has made, he deserves like a mulligan.
A mulligan like in golf?
Yeah.
For the Aguilar one?
Yeah.
All right, buddy. We'll see you next Sunday when we talk if we have
News.
News on a new Brewer player. So Tuesday, Wednesday, they're off today, the 26th. Yes. Then we go to Pittsburgh.
Pirates.
And they're in last place.
Yep.
And then we go to the old Milwaukee team, the Braves.
They just destroy them. I always hope they destroy the Braves.
How are the Braves doing this year?
They're in third place.
Third place?
And, around 500.
Okay. All right, hey, let's go with the standings.
Okay.
That's hot off the press. This is as of this morning.
Yes. The Milwaukee Brewers are in first place. The Cincinnati Reds are 6.5 games back. The Cardinals are surprisingly in third place, 8 games back. The Chicago Cubs 9 games back, they will be active at the trade deadline, but in reverse, then they will be selling players, not buying. And the Pittsburgh Pirates are in last place, 19.5 games back.
Well, what do you say? We're going to cut it short. I think we talked a little bit about the Bucks.
Yeah, this it starts and sinking for me. Yeah, I mean, because they were just so awful in the past, I just didn't think they would win a championship, but they did, and it's amazing.
All right. What do you have to say to your fans?
Thanks for watching, and come back next week.
Go Bucks go, right, Peyton?
Yeah, go Bucks go.
Fear the what?
Fear the deal.
A little bit of that, and yeah. A little bit of Queen.
Yes.
August is coming up.
Yes.
Trade deadline.
Yes.
I think Tucker's still drinking champagne.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. I feel sorry for his wife.
And Giannis is at what, Chick-fil-A?
No, not anymore. He, Culver's. I think he switched allegiance to.
What did Culver's do?
A day after they won the championship, he ordered 50 chicken nuggets. Not 49, not 51. But 50 chicken nuggets from Chick-fil-A, and he asked waiter after that, he asked Chick-fil-A if he could get free chicken nuggets for life.
For life, right?
And they wouldn't respond for some reason, but Culver's near Milwaukee responded.
They're going
to
do that?
So I think he switched his allegiance.
Little wave to your fans, buddy.
Okay. Is that a great deal, man?
Oh, yeah. Go Bucks!
Go Bucks!